It would apply to the congressman as well. Congressman Bass.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman, and I would like to have my statement made a part of the record. I appreciate the opportunity to testify before the committee today. My home state of New Hampshire, I believe, is an excellent example of a state with a diverse economy and a manufacturing sector. We have low unemployment, less than 5%, 4.7% last statistics. We have a highly educated, highly skilled workforce and a lower tax rate than 49 other states in America. We have small government, and we have an economy, I think, that benefits from those factors. I hope that my perspective, both as a manufacturer and as a representative of the state of New Hampshire, can be useful in this discussion. We have large employers, BAE Systems, employing more than 5,000 people in the defense industry. In fact, 11% of the total output of our economy is directly associated with manufacturing. But it hasn't always been that way, or put it this way, the output hasn't been the same. My ancestors settled in the state of New Hampshire in the mid-1700s. They were farmers, and they grew flax, and it was a miserable existence. Their children built the Phoenix Mill in Peterborough, New Hampshire, which was a manufacturer it was a textile manufacturer. They took the sheep and so forth and started making clothing. Throughout the next 200 years, the economy evolved in the state as a manufacturing economy, in textiles, in shoes. In the 50s, New Hampshire was one of the leading defense contractors in the country. In the early to late 90s, New Hampshire was number two in the nation for high-tech employees. And now where are we today? Well, as Senator Stabenow so articulately discussed, we are hoping to be able to lead the way in the development of technologies in the area of alternative energy. And it's one of my passions in my, shall we say, my new life here in the U.S. Congress. All in all, we survive because we have an environment where we create the ability for manufacturers to thrive in an environment that supports entrepreneurship. It believes that capitalism is not a dirty word, where the need for a safe workplace, for good environmental controls, for good access to products and make sure they are what they are supposed to be, where that is balanced with the need not to tie down our business community to the extent that they are spending unnecessary sums of money and labor trying to meet regulations that are not necessarily in the best interest of anybody. I ran for Congress in 1994 the tipping point in my company. I went to the Xerox machine one day. This was in 1994. And there was this enormous placard over the machine that the Xerox maintenance guy had put up there. And it explained chapter after chapter after chapter about how I needed to do this or that in order to copy paper because the toner that was in there might harm me forever. And I had been using this machine for 10 years. I felt fine. And I couldn't believe, I asked the Xerox guy, and he said, oh, we have to put that up there now. It's part of the rules, and you have to read it, and we're going to have to tell you about it. He said, something is wrong here. Something is wrong. And I own we owned a manufacturing facility that was in full compliance with OSHA. Then MOSHA appeared. Now, it was in a state, starts with M. MOSHA's regulations were different from OSHA's regulations. So we didn't know which set of regulations in our factory we were supposed to follow, because if we followed MOSHA, we might be in noncompliance with OSHA and vice versa. It was very perplexing. This is not good for manufacturing in America. Now, I'm in favor of anybody, of a safe workplace, but we have to apply a level of cost benefit to all the interrelationship between government and manufacturers. Like many of us here, I watch occasionally shows on TV. There's one I recall called How It's Made. And if you can get by the obnoxious music, it's really quite extraordinary the level of sophistication that we have in manufacturing. And every one of those little shows is about American manufacturing and how diverse we can be. If we can keep our tax rates competitive globally, if we can balance regulations so that the consumers and public and working Americans are safe, yet we can compete with other manufacturers around the world, we will stay ahead of China. We're well-educated. We are like 10 to 1 more productive on a per capita basis than Chinese workers. But we need to have a good competitive workplace. We need to be able to trade, and we need to be able to continue to have a well-educated workforce. We don't need the government to tell us how to succeed in manufacturing. I've done it, and I did it without any help from the U.S. government. Thank you very much.
Congressman, thank you very much. As is often the case when members of the